Hello everyone, my name is Noah from Tetron Invest, and today I'm going to be going over the theory of the MOASS, the mother of all short squeezes. What the hell does that even mean? Why does everybody say it? When's it going to happen? First of all, not a financial advisor, simply thoughts and opinions in this video, and I want to keep it short and sweet, but what exactly is the MOASS? So the theory of the ultimate short squeeze is that because the short interest was over 100% and now it's only listed as like 10, 15, but anybody who's been following this most likely thinks slash knows synthetic shares are out there. The price has been suppressed slash manipulated for a while, right? So at some point though, all shorts must cover. Even if the short interest has been hidden, which we could get into in another video, and there are many, many theories kind of proving this and really have me convinced, but we'll see. If that is the case, shorts must cover. If more than 100% of a stock is shorted, how can you cover more shares than exist, right? And now everyone's locking up the float. Everybody's DRS'd computer share, right? So the shares are in their individual names. So there's limited shares available on the market. So why does this matter? Okay, let's say half GME shares are in DRS right now. They can't be shorted. Nobody's touching them. Let's say, that's just for example's sake, right? So there's 72 million float, approx. 36 million is locked up. Now you got 36 million left. And oh, the float was shorted over 100%. Now they have to go buy over 72 million shares. And the idea is of the MOASS, if they're buying like theoretically hundreds of millions of shares and we have so much of the float, individual investors have so much of the float locked up, right? The float is locked, or not locked, but in control, can't be shorted. When they go to buy to cover, eventually those positions, the idea is that it will be so powerful, so much buying all at once, to the point it literally empties the order books. What do I mean by that? Every single sell order will be instantly filled. And then when you sell, it'll instantly fill at any price. What? Why? How? How's that possible? Okay, imagine in that scenario I said before, there's only 36 million shares left. Somebody gets a margin call or something goes out of business. A hedge fund goes out of business. And they get liquidated and they have to buy to cover 45 million shares. Or let's say even it's like a smaller number, right? Like a more realistic 10 million. Even though that's less than what the float is locked, how do you know who's selling? If nobody's selling, then it's all these buy orders on the books and there's no sells. If it's all buy orders and the buying becomes so overwhelming, because if you don't find a price to buy at, you just keep going up. Buy higher, buy higher, buy higher, buy. What if there's nothing higher? What if nothing's up there? The price is infinite. It's just as high as you want. Oh, I have a share. Oh, I look at the order books. I own some shares. Looks like everyone needs shares. There's literally none available for sale. I'll sell mine for 5,000. Instant sell. Because if it's a margin call, they have to buy at market price. It doesn't matter. If it's a failure to deliver, they have to buy at market price. It doesn't matter. If it's covering options or some kind of foolery with options, you have to buy at market price if you owe the shares. And if the shares keep getting locked up with individuals, they can only pull this cheese for so long. They've been jerking us around as us, as in individual GameStop shareholders, since January. Just look at that chart. Look at the volume compared to January, and as time has gone on, and as DRS has become relevant, volume keeps decreasing because less shares are trading back and forth each day. And that means more and more shares are theoretically just being held by individual investors. And more often than not, it's computer share. And why computer share matters is because shares in computer share cannot be shorted. They legally cannot be shorted because they're in your individual name, not in the name of your brokerage. Whereas if you own the shares in Fidelity, TD, Robinhood, shares aren't in your name. They could be lent out, and your shares, without you even knowing, could be being lent out. That's crazy. And then basically, if they're lending out your shares, that means somebody's shorting them. So they're basically using your position against you to make money. And that's why everyone's gotten to computer share on Reddit, and the big movement has come, and a lot of interesting things going on. And I really do follow social sentiment, and I think that certainly helps. And GameStop is just the most misunderstood investment right now. It's as simple as that. It's the risk versus reward on this, and being a young individual investor, it's absolutely something I want to take. It's not for everybody. No. Should it be a large percentage of your portfolio like it is mine? Probably not. But I'm young. I can afford to take that chance. I'm just starting this channel. I'm just starting this business. Like, I'm 21 years old. Like, if there's a time to take a chance on something with such good risk to reward potential, in my opinion, the reward, the upside is so massive, why not? It's worth it. I believe in the company. I believe in what they're doing. I'm not just like, ooh, I hope the MOASS comes. Ooh, it'll be so good. Ooh, I'll be rich. I want to get rich quick. No, I believe in it. I believe in what I've read, my due diligence. So for that reason, I'm comfortable with taking this big risk. But kind of went off on a limb here. I was trying to keep this short, but hope this information helped. Please comment with questions, concerns, theories, thoughts, anything. I want to communicate with people about GameStop. Have a great day.